Welcome. Today we're going to take a look at an integrated drive generator malfunction. The integrated drive generator is referred to its initials, IDG. The IDG is an electrical generator. It converts variable engine speed into a constant 24,000 RPM, which runs an AC generator, producing electricity for aircraft systems. There is an IDG on each engine, mounted on the accessory gearbox, beneath the starter motor. As soon as the master caution light illuminates, the pilot flying states,
"My aircraft."
Autopilot, A, disengaged, so let's select autopilot B. The master caution light can be pressed to avoid distraction. Looking at the overhead panel, we can see a drive light illuminated, as well as a source off light and generator off bus light. The drive light is illuminated by various conditions. IDG failure, engine shutdown, high oil temperature, low oil pressure, or manual disconnect. The loss of a functioning generator has resulted in an electrical source being off and generator off bus condition. Therefore, using the terminology of the light, the drive non-normal checklist is called for. After checking the QRC, if applicable, the drive checklist can be found in the index of the Quick Reference Handbook, known as QRH. It directs us to go to page 6.1. To ensure it is the correct checklist, the pilot monitoring reads the procedure title and condition to the pilot flying, and seeks confirmation if it is the correct checklist before continuing.
Drive checklist. Condition: a generator drive malfunction occurs. Do you agree?
I agree.
With both pilots agreeing it is the correct checklist, it can now be performed. Note, the graphic to the top left of the checklist matches the illuminated light, giving additional confirmation this is the correct checklist. Step 1 starts with a warning that the action in step 1 is not reversible. It directs to use the generator drive disconnect switch on the affected side to disconnect the IDG from the engine. A note below states this prevents generator drive damage. This step is not reversible, as the IDG can only then be reconnected by maintenance on the ground. A mistake in disconnecting the good IDG would result in losing both engine generators. Notice this step contains the word confirm. This means that both pilots are required to confirm the correct switch is about to be moved before doing so. Step 2 is conditional: is the APU available for start or not? Our APU is available, so select the first path, which directs us to start the APU. The purpose in starting the APU is to use it as an additional power source. The checklist then states in bold letters, when the APU is running, to switch on the APU generator switch on the affected side. The four black boxes within this path indicate the checklist has been completed. The pilot monitoring then states,
"Drive checklist complete."
Had the APU not been available, we would have planned to land at the nearest suitable airport, as only one main AC power source would have remained. Let's take another look, this time from the first officer's viewpoint. Once the annunciation is noted, the master caution light can be extinguished. This time it's the number 2 IDG that has malfunctioned, and the autopilot remained engaged. The checklist is followed, and the IDG disconnected. The APU is started. And when running, is selected as a power source. The AC and DC metering panel can be used to see the AC frequency and volts provided by each generator. Please click like if you enjoyed this look at the non-normal procedure for an IDG malfunction. And if not already, please subscribe to learn of our future videos, when we'll learn more about the 737. Thank you.